Hey everyone, I'm Alex Noonan. I'm a developer advocate at Dagster Labs, and today I'm doing another video in our series around Dagster best practices, where we show you tips and tricks to get started faster and ship more confidently in Dagster. And today I'm going to be talking all about asset metadata, so you can better organize your data platform and embed critical documentation into your workflows, making your platform easier to use for everybody involved. In this video, I'll show you how to transform your data platform from a black box into something that your entire team can understand, debug, and trust. So here's the thing about data platforms. They're complicated. Sure, data flows from point A to point B, but when something breaks, and it will break, you're left playing detective instead of solving like an actual problem. And we've all been there asking questions like, who built this? Where does this data actually represent? When was it last updated? And is this the table that finance uses for their quarterly reports? Asset metadata in Dagster solves this by giving every piece of data context, ownership, and history. Now let's get started with the basics. When you define asset ownership, you can do that right in the asset decorator by simply defining owners, and you can do that for individuals or teams like so. And now when this asset has issues, there's no guessing game. The owner will get pinged, and if they're on vacation, anybody on the data engineering team can step in, and it's that simple. And tags can take this a step further by creating a structure around your growing data platform. And tags are super flexible since they're just JSON, so you can put whatever sort of organization scheme in there. And the benefit of this is you can simply assign context. For example, if compliance comes in and they want to see all the assets with PII and whether they are visible in like downstream reports, they can simply go into the UI and search by the tag of PII, and from there, they can see all the assets and any upstream and downstream connections from them. When it comes to documentation, code works really well as a source of documentation. For one, it's checked into version control, so you can see the most up-to-date version. Two, it is right embedded in the work stream that the developers use, so it's going to be more up-to-date. And it's more lightweight than using some external system or a wiki that, let's be honest, probably is never going to get updated. And with Dagster, you can just put any metadata you want right in the asset decorator. And this will all appear in the Dagster UI, so you can read it right there. But just imagine if a new engineer comes on board, you can just give them access to the Dagster instance and the repo, and they can understand and explore the assets themselves. And if the descriptions are there, they can quickly understand what it's about and the context of the asset. And one of my favorite things to do with Dagster is input runtime metadata. So any time that an asset materializes, you can have it display specific metrics that are entirely customizable by you right in the UI. And I use this a lot for like a data frame to show like what the columns are, the column types. So you don't have to print it out. If you're developing locally, you can just hop into the UI and see when it last ran, and you can see what the data looks like. Additionally, you can attach the code source for a specific asset and have it surface in the UI. We use this in our internal Dagster implementation, and you can check it out for yourself. The link will be in the description. And this is just really helpful for if you have a really complex data platform with like thousands of assets and you really want to go to the source, you can just click right at the link and it'll show you the code that generates the asset. And one of the key benefits of using this asset metadata beyond the organizational and documentation benefits is you can use these tags to power additional alerting or automation or any other kind of intelligent features to get the most out of your data platform and have rules that are applied consistently to your assets, regardless whether they are native Dagster assets or from an integration. And when you're working as a team, having a comprehensive and thoughtful metadata approach serves everyone. For example, the data engineers can use schema and code references for debugging and maintenance. Analytics teams that rely on the documentation and column descriptions can do better analysis more quickly. Data product managers can filter by domain and critically understand the entire data estate. And platform teams can use ownership and quality metrics for governance and SLA monitoring. And business stakeholders can actually understand the data they have and what they're looking at. And if you're a Dagster Plus user, all this rich metadata that you're inputting into your assets will surface in the catalog, making it more useful for you. And you can leverage the asset selection syntax to really drill down what you want to see. And you can set up alerts and leverage our in-app reporting to really understand and track your data platform more effectively. And this isn't just about organization. It's about making a data platform that people actually want to work with instead of something that they have to fight with constantly to get what they need. And if you have an existing platform that doesn't have this metadata in place, well, the best time to start is right now. So you should pick your most critical assets and add basic ownership and documentation and tags, and then gradually layer in schema information, quality metrics, and observability data. And remember, the goal isn't great metadata from day one. It's building a culture where context and clarity are part of how you build data products. And every piece of metadata that you add makes your platform more reliable, more discoverable, and more maintainable. So be kinder to your future self. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.